to dedicate that song tonight to Sir George Martin. A great guy, and been so many great times. You know, I was talking about the very first record, the little amateur record we made, and of course George is the guy who signed us and gave us our record contract and our record career. We wouldn't be here without him. In fact, I was thinking of the story when we did Love Me Do. We got into the studio and we were just really young kids, you know, we were like 20, I think. And so we came in, we had to come in like the back door. We weren't allowed in the control room, that was like for the grown-ups. So we came in, you know, and so we started playing Love Me Do. And John was on harmonica, so it went, Love Me Do. And George said, could we actually have it so that John starts the harmonica on the one? So it should go, Love Me. So he said, Paul, he says, would you mind singing Love Me Do live? But up until then, John had always sung it, so I was like, oh no, you know, panic. So he says, would you mind singing it? I go, yeah, okay. To this day, I can hear the nerves in my voice all over. I hear that record, Love Me Do. Sometimes ask about how songs get written. This next one, I was over at John's house one day and we were looking for an idea for a song, and he had this poster on his wall, which is an old circus poster, and we're looking at it, we're reading it, it says, be it for the benefit of Mr. Kite, the horses, and the horse. So we ended up, we kind of just wrote it down, didn't we? And that's this next song.
Mr. K.